Dear students, I welcome you all for this screencast lecture. This lecture is about the various questions what we are going to cover in this particular subject. This screencast lecture is prepared based on the questions that have been asked in the previous semester and some important questions there related to our subject. Totally, I have prepared around 26 questions. In these 26 questions, there will be a huge possibility for asking most of the questions there in your term and examination or in the semester examination. So, these things have been posted there in our web page under the topic semester examination. First of all, we will go into an introduction and then we start into the points related for the first question. Most of the questions I have listed here is of a 10 mark question. Okay, from there they can able to ask something in a 1 mark or in a 7 mark as per the marks that have been allocated there in your question paper. So we look at into the first question, that is, write an essay on the role of microbes in soil fertility. Here comes first the definition there for the soil and agriculture microbiology. Especially agriculture microbiology. Soil microbiology refers to microorganisms that have been present in the soil, studied with the help of a microbiology, that is soil microbiology. Agriculture microbiology is a branch of microbiology that deals with the microbes of agricultural importance and their role in maintenance of a soil fertility and crop productivity. How much they can able to make the soil fertile and how much they can able to make the productivity of the crop. So, in order to get a good crop, following things are essentially required in any kind of a system. A favorable genetic makeup of the plant is very important. That is, plant should have all the genes that are required to be properly expressed for the formation of a fruit, seeds, flowers, and a proper growth of the plant is required. Second one, correct balance of the minerals should be present in the soil. This minerals includes both macro and micronutrient that have been present in the soil. Macronutrient refers to carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, phosphorus. Carbon is the one which can be taken up by the plant merely by a carbon fixation process, since they are all photosynthetic in nature. Whereas the other nutrients are all need to be supplied there. And the second one, micronutrient, it refers to iron, zinc, copper, manganese. These are all coming under a micronutrient that are required in a micro quantities for their growth. So this is very important. And next one, mobility of this particular nutrient there in the soil system as well as in the plant system. How much they are all mobile or they can able to move there in the soil system. Why this question is arising is, sometimes this minerals or this nutrient will be fixed there to the clay substance that have been present in the soil or to any other mineral component present in the soil. As a result, they will not be much mobile. So their mobility and their mobility inside the plant systems are very important with reference to their availability. The third one is presence of beneficial microbes. Microbes that can able to improve the plant growth. Fourth one is absence of pathogenic microbes. Microbes that can able to cause disease on the plant system. Such kind of microbes should not be present there in the soil. So if you look into the soil, a 25% is covered there with the air and 25% is with the water, and 45% constitutes the mineral particle. The mineral particle is the one in which mainly inorganic nutrients will be present, or the inorganic micro and macro elements will be present there. The remaining small portion of 5% goes to the organic matter. Organic matter is again composed of organisms that have been present there. What are all the organisms? Just look at the thing here. These are all the various kind of organisms that may be present there in the soil system. So these all organisms will be present there in the soil system, which constitutes there into the 10% of the organism. Then the roots, 10% of roots. Roots is the point which is already known for you. I don't need to explain. And the third one is a humus. Humus refers to some portion of the soil content that cannot be degraded by any kind of an organism. A organic matter portion that is tough to undergo any kind of a degradation is referred as a humus. We will see the detail of the humus in a subsequent classes. I told only the soil will be having different kinds of minerals. These are all the various minerals that will be present there in the soil. Sand, silt, clay. Sand is the one which is having a larger size, whereas clay is the one which is having a smaller size. And these are the one that will be proportionately or disproportionately also distributed there in a soil system. Then if you make a cross section of the soil system, it will be just looking like this. Microorganisms present in the soil are all listed there in the right hand side. That is bacteria, which includes cyanobacteria, actinobacteria, and all are kind of autotrophic as well as heterotrophic bacteria. Then comes fungi, algae, protists, nematodes, and viruses. Viruses have been shown in a very dull. The reason is number of viruses in the soil or importance of viruses with reference to plant growth is very meager. That's the reason we are not going to cover there on into the viruses. If you look at into this diagram, you can able to find what are all the portions in which are all the type of microorganism that have been present there. Say you can able to see the root surface here and root hair you can able to see, and then you can able to see the bacterial colonies that have been adhering there to the roots. You can able to see a hyphae that is of a mycorrhizal in origin. You can also able to see a hyphae is of a actinorhizal in origin. The difference will be size of the hyphae. Mycorrhizal hyphae will be of a larger size, whereas actinomycorrhizal hyphae will be of a very small size. That is the reason why actinomyces were also referred as a thread bacteria. So you can able to see some decomposing plant cells and even the clay organic matter complexes. So this is a clay structure. This one is a large one, a sand structure, and a in between that thing can be of a silt structure. So they are all bounded together there in the soil. Say for example, clay is attaching there with the organic matter complex and it is present there. Then you can able to see a fungal hyphae that have been present adhering to the soil particles. Flagellates, ciliates, amoeba, these are all refers to various protozoas that have been present there in the soil. You can able to see a tiny insect is also present there in the soil. They are called as a mites. Some kind of a mites may also present there in the soil. You can able to see a nematode. Here this is a nematode that have been present there in the soil. And this here also you can able to see a nematode. So these are all the various kind of microorganisms that can be found there in the soil system. Now we look at into the role they are playing there in the soil system. So these are all the various kinds of roles that have been playing there in the soil system. I have listed a huge list, that is up to 19 different roles that have been played by microbes there in the soil system that can able to increase the soil fertility. Fertility refers to capacity of the soil to feed the plant system and crop productivity. So here the first one is fixation of carbon by green algae and carbon and nitrogen by cyanobacteria. Green algae are always associated with carbon fixation alone. So they are all the first colonizer there in any kind of a soil system. Then comes the cyanobacteria, which has the ability to fix both carbon and nitrogen. After availability of carbon and nitrogen in an ecosystem, it will start flourishing with the other groups of organisms such as the fungi, heterotrophic bacteria, lichens. Lichens is the one which is having an association of a cyanobacteria or green algae and fungi and mosses. These are all lead finally to the formation of a biological soil crust. The next one is the diazotrophs, that is nitrogen fixing organism. There is various kind of bacteria that can able to fix nitrogen. If you closely look at some points I have highlighted in yellow color, the reason behind this thing is these points are going to be elaborated in the coming classes. So when they are asking this question as a 10 mark question, you can add the points that have been taught in the other classes also here. That is, you can list the 19 points. After that, a few points can be explained in detail. Those points are I have marked there in yellow color. And the next one is a phytohormone. As like we have a various kind of hormone system in our body, plants also require a lot of hormone. That includes the IAA, cytokinin, gibberellin. These are all the various hormones that are required for the plant activity. Then phosphorus and other mineral solubilization. Phosphorus is the one which is commonly present in the soil as a unavailable form that can be easily solubilized by various kind of heterotrophic organism, mainly through the production of organic acids. Then mineralization of organic nitrogen, sulfur and phosphorus. These are all the things which will take place mainly during the biogeochemical cycling of the nutrient. That is the one I have given there in the 8th point also. This biogeochemical cycling refers to how in the nature the nutrients are all cycled, which includes how carbon cycle is operating, nitrogen cycle, phosphorus cycle and sulfur cycle are all operating. And the next one refers to polysaccharide production and improvement in the soil aggregation. These images clearly explain the point of soil aggregation. So you can able to see the soil particles are aggregated there by the growth of fungi. So fungi hyphae is being formed, which is aggregating the various kind of soil aggregates. So it can be referred as a macroaggregate, microaggregate, submicroaggregate, and the primary particles, as I have already explained, silt, clay and sand are all aggregated together by microbial debris as well as the various kind of hyphae which produced by fungi, actinobacteria, they are all making the aggregation there. Again, this aggregation will be favored by production of some kind of a gummy substances there in the soil. Say for example, rhizobium produces a lot of polysaccharides, and even the mycorrhiza produces a specific kind of a polysaccharide called as a glomalin, which improves the aggregation there in the soil system. So this is also again a image shows, a electron microscopic image shows how an aggregation has been carried out there in the soil. The right hand side you can able to see a rhizobium colony grown in the plate, which is so gummy in appearance. So this is a way in which they can able to create an aggregation there. The next one is organic matter degradation, which includes the mineralization and immobilization. We are going to see in detail in the coming classes about the organic matter decomposition. It includes cellulose, hemicellulose, lignin, they are all how it's degraded. Biogeochemical cycling separately we are going to see. And the next one is the production of metal chelators, that includes the siderophore. Siderophore are those that is involved in chelating the iron molecule and make it available for the plant system. The next one is production of certain plant growth modulating enzyme. This is ACC deaminase enzyme. This enzyme production increases the plant growth. Production of organic volatile compounds promoting plant growth. This includes ammonia production there in the soil system that can able to improve the plant growth. Increase in root area that is effected through the mycorrhiza. The root area formation that is increased are commonly mediated more by mycorrhiza. This helps in the water uptake and resistant against the various kind of pathogens as well as the water stress. Hydrogen oxidizing bacteria, they are also playing a major role there. Then biocontrol and antibiasis, this we are going to see as a separate chapter there in the 4th or 5th unit I think. Then the other points includes the induced systemic resistance, which is called as a ISR. So the details about these things are all we will see in the biocontrol and antibiasis on this top, on that particular topic. The potential to degrade certain pesticides and contaminants, that is xenobiotic degradation, will be very clearly explained in your other paper, that is environmental microbiology. Proton extrusion enhancers and mineral uptake facilitators, these are all certain groups of organisms which can again able to improve the plant growth. Then production of vitamins, as like human body requires a lot of vitamins, the plants are also requiring a lot of vitamin for their growth. So these vitamins are all produced by certain soil microorganisms. And then the last point is enhanced stress resistance, that is against salt, drought, metal, xenobiotics. These are all imparted there to the plant system with the help of microorganism. That is, if a microorganism is present there, the plant can able to tolerate the drought condition. One very clear example is when methylobacterium is sprayed there in the leaf surface, it can able to protect the plant against the drought. So this some details we will again see under the topic of plant growth promoting rhizobacteria. So these are all the various kind of a role that is played by the microorganism in order to maintain the soil fertility and crop productivity. You can list this role and you can explain a few there. Thank you.